Yo, what's up? God, it's been 3 years already. All right, that was kind of embarrassing. Okay, give me like 5 minutes to get ready. Hold up, I'll be right back.
All right, so here in 2023, Apple has really all but gotten rid of the Touch Bar, with only the 13-inch MacBook Pro still actually shipping with it. And although I agree with most people that like it left a lot to be desired, I also still really like having it in my own laptop. And like when I moved to a mechanical keyboard recently, I actually found myself missing some select features. So let's take a look at what exactly went wrong and how this type of feature could be re-implemented in the future. So it seems to me that the biggest factor that led to the failure of the Touch Bar was largely just a failure to get developers to add it to their apps. Like to this day, I still don't see many apps that actively use the Touch Bar to enhance the experience of their pre-existing software. And this sort of leads me to my first point here, which is that in many cases, things that can be done with the Touch Bar are just as easily done with keyboard shortcuts. So let's take a look within Final Cut. Like the tool switcher, media selection controls, and trim functions are already keybound. And it's just easier to use the keyboard than it is to like move my hand up to use the Touch Bar. Like, I guess as a general rule, if a function is a discrete variable, as in like on or off, there's really no need to put it on the Touch Bar. So given all this, it seems that where the Touch Bar could really shine is in places where a continuous type of input is required for a given use case. Like looking at creative applications, professionals pay hundreds of dollars for dials and sliders to add to their desk workflow, to adjust things like audio levels in Logic or opacity in Final Cut. They kind of just make sense, especially since these variables can be super frustrating to keybind. Like, the increment by which you want to adjust these variables can vary by the use case. But okay, even beyond this, it seems that the biggest feature that could improve the Touch Bar would just be more customization within apps. Like we've seen the ability to customize system functions for a while, but when it comes to specific apps, it's pretty rare. But of course, like this is sort of critical because everyone has like their own workflow and not everyone will use the same functions at any given time. Like, take a look here. If I'm working on coloring a project, I don't want to have the trim buttons taking up space on the Touch Bar. So being able to choose what functions are seen in certain workspaces or apps could really improve the usability of the Touch Bar. All right, now don't get me wrong. There are parts of the current iteration of the Touch Bar that I make good use of on a daily basis. Things like predictive text is legitimately useful, and it's far more intuitive than using F5 to toggle through options. But unfortunately, these types of features are pretty few and far between as it stands.
Look, I really want to love the Touch Bar because like having a way to control continuous variables is something that like many creative professionals pay hundreds of dollars for. Like having that built into a laptop is something that could be super powerful. But the fact of the matter is that this iteration just didn't quite work out. So my hope is that, you know, sometime in the distant future, Apple gives this type of feature another try. But until then, thank you so much for watching, and yeah, have a great day.